himself, the man behind the kit. Producer extraordinaire, one of the great producers of our time, Mr. H. Liam is back.
What can only be lightly described as a painful wait. We have brand new music called Nasty. Must be the governor on the phone. What's up, Liam H?
Howdy, man. How you doing?
I'm doing great. You guys have been burrowed down in the Prodigy bunker for a long time making this record, and we're about to release it. I mean, even a seasoned pro like you, do you get excited at moments like this?
Oh, yeah, man. It's been a long one, this one. I've enjoyed writing it. Must admit, really enjoyed the whole process this time. But yeah, it's kind of like, you just get to sit back and just listen to what you've done, and just, I'm proud of it, It's just, it's a good moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're dying to hear the music, and we'll take a few minutes to catch up with Liam in a second. But without further ado, the hottest record in the world from the forthcoming new album, The Day Is My Enemy. This is the Prodigy in fighting form. This is Nasty.
This ish is exclusive. Pay attention.
My main man Zane is about to put the hottest.
This is the hottest record in the world right now.
That's kind of everything the Prodigy fans are probably expecting, I'd imagine. That's Keith Flint up front attacking. That's a heavy riff combined with those drums of doom. That is Prodigy TM. Liam Howlett's on the phone. And why Nasty? Why that first statement from the album, bro?
Well, we were flicking through various options for the first record, and it felt like really direct and just like, it's undeniable us, so it's kind of, we wanted people just to kind of get the full force of that and the attack, do you know what I mean? As you say, it feels just really simple and direct for us, and we know it's going to rock live, that track,
Anybody who's met Keith or has seen him in person offstage and out of the booth knows that, the guy lives the most holistic, peaceful existence known to man these days. When you get him in the booth... when you get him in the booth like that and he sounds as firing as ever, without giving away too much, does he have to get himself into a certain frame of mind in order to get into that space?
I don't know what people's impression of Keith is, really, but, Keith is great and unhinged as he's ever been, so it's kind of like, he's, when he comes into the studio, he's just totally, just nails it. It's usually first take with Keith, job done, but I mean, both Keith and Maxim all over this album, I think he's the best lyrics they've done, best vocal performances, so this album is more a band album, really, than the last album,
More collaborative than we've come to expect with the last two records, including this one. I mean, Sleaford Mods on a track, Flux Pavilion with you as well, carving something up. Opening the door and getting those new influences into the studio, I suppose at times when you've been working on a record for over a year, it must be a real breath of fresh air too.
Yeah, man. I mean, basically, I'm usually against doing collaborations, it just felt, especially working with Jason from Sleaford's, it just brought another different angle. And usually collaborations feel disjointed on a record, and we wanted the record to feel like a band record, but Ibiza, which is the track you're talking about, yeah. I mean, it's killer. It's the anti-hit, this record, It's great. And it's what I was going to say, that it's got Jason and Keith on it, so it's kind of Keith's on the chorus with Jason, but it just feels like it's more part of the album than a disjointed collaboration.
14 songs on the forthcoming new album as well. It's wall-to-wall Prodigy. You've given the people a lot of music in a day and age when, a lot of people are putting out EPs and singles, and I love the fact that you've given people a lot of value.
Yeah, man. I mean, we had more tracks, but it's just like, these were just the ones we felt made up for good record. I mean, obviously people have seen us play in the last 2 years. They've heard various tracks like Jetfire, AWOL. They just didn't make the grades, do you know what I mean? It's, like, really important, I think, to have, a few different things that surprise people, and there's definitely that on this album,
If I could just give people an insight into what to expect, it's there in front of me in these 14 songs with song titles like The Day Is My Enemy, Nasty, Rebel Radio, Destroy, Rockweller, Beyond the Death Ray, Rhythm Bomb, Get Your Fight On, and Wall of Death. Needless to say, this isn't you guys in a mellow mood.
Well, no, we can't exist in that mellow mood, can we? We only operate in one mode. So it's like, it's really important for us to be able to play this record live and just attack, do you know what I mean, sonically. And, we're really both with it, and just like, we know when we play it live, it's just going to work.
Liam Howlett's on the phone. Before we let you go, bro, tour dates, we have to talk about them because they're out now and people are buzzing about the fact you're on the road official, not just doing festivals and random headline slots. Like, you know, going out and playing these kind of rooms, which you won't have played for some time, not since the beginning of the Invaders tour, I'd imagine.
Yeah, I mean, basically, like, it's not an arena tour. We wanted to kind of do something a bit smaller first, you know what I mean? So we're excited to be going into that kind of size venue, do you know what I mean? And, you know, we'll reach those bigger ones later on in the year. Yeah, it's going to be great. Two Ali Pallies. We've never played Ali Pally before, so it's going to be exciting. Because he's right in my house, so it's cool. I'll walk home. Yeah.
In case you missed it, two times we played already, Nasty Nasty from the Prodigy coming your way tonight again at 8:30 p.m. on Radio 1. And I just can't wait to play more from this album, Liam. Thanks, bro.
Cheers, man. Respect.